Yesterday, the State Department officially lifted its designation of Cuba as a state sponsor of terrorism. It's one of the many recent steps by the Obama administration to reestablish diplomatic ties between the island nation and the United States. Here to talk about the implications of that move is Carla Robinson, adjunct senior fellow at the Council on Foreign Relations. So, first of all, this was on the list since the early 80s. What put them on this list of state sponsors of terror in the first place?
Exporting revolution, cozy relations with the FARC in Colombia, cozy relations with the Basque terrorists, ETA, and we didn't like them.
Right. And then now, if they're off this list, what does it mean?
It means more than anything else that U.S. banks can have relations with Cuban banks, which will make it much easier to follow through on the easing of financial relations that Obama is promoting. And the Cubans said it was the biggest precondition for reestablishing direct diplomatic relations, opening the embassies.
So in a practical matter, this means that if a tourist is visiting Cuba, their ATM cards or their credit cards will work.
That's the idea. Right now, MasterCard is there, I believe. I think American Express is there, but you can't, there's no American bank that can do it because of fear that the Treasury Department will punish you. You know, these terrorism lists, particularly since 9/11, I mean, U.S. banks have been paying very, very high penalties for it. So now you'll be able to do that. And more than anything else, while the embargo is still in place and will remain in place for a very long time, I suspect, you can do business with private businesses in Cuba, a variety of other trade. We can sell medicines, we can sell agriculture. We've been able to do that for quite a while. But the Cubans had to pay before. They had to, had to send the money here, couldn't do it through an American bank. It was a very complicated process. Now, they're going to be able to clear checks in Cuba, and that's a big deal. Not an enormous boon. There's not going to be a huge, gold rush here, but it's going to make it easier to do financial transactions.
So you pointed out that distinction that this still does not mean that the embargo is lifted. That is a much bigger scenario, and that takes congressional approval.
The embargo was an executive order since Kennedy all the way through till Clinton. It was written into law during the Clinton administration, not at the behest of the White House. The Republicans pushed it. And so now Congress has to agree to do it. And what's really interesting, I was up on the Hill a few weeks ago, and I was really surprised to see that nobody on the Hill was really going to make a big fight about this lifting of the, the terrorism list. They're not going to fight Obama on all of these other things. On the other hand, nobody's going to push very hard to lift the embargo. This is a very long process.
Right. And there are still significant disagreements that the two countries have. I mean, the Secretary of State said that yesterday. There's obviously members of Congress that say that.
Having diplomatic relations doesn't mean that we love them. Mm-hmm. And ultimately, the U.S. and Cuba have very different goals for this rapprochement. Obama has been very clear. His goal here, to have closer contact, is to promote democratic change in Cuba. The Cubans' goal for this is to get enough, economic bailout so they can maintain the repressive society for a little bit longer. I think ultimately, the Castro brothers are very old. Ultimately, Cuba's going to move towards some sort of reforms. And I think, as President Obama says, we've had 50 years of this policy and it didn't work. Mm-hmm.
So when these two countries start to establish embassies officially in each other's countries, what are the kinds of steps that we will see towards this diplomatic kind of normalization?
Right. I think the biggest issue right now, and we don't know how soon the opening could come, the official opening, if I had to bet, probably sooner rather than later. Mm-hmm. The biggest questions, I think, what they've been going back and forth is the Cubans keep saying, we don't want you to be using the embassy to continue to do what you've been doing, which is giving training journalists and meeting with dissidents. And the Americans keep saying, what are you talking about? We want to do this. I hope the Obama administration doesn't give up too much about that, although they've been signaling that in other authoritarian societies there are restrictions, and they will place restrictions on the Cubans themselves. This is not going to be a warm and cuddly relationship for a very long time, I suspect.
All right, Carla Robbins, thanks so much.
Thank you.